welcome to another collection of sparkling calls from the Car Talk archives.
Sparkling? What'd you do, spill ginger ale on the tapes?
I did, as a matter of fact. Anyway, the subject of this collection is couples.
Yes, couples and relationships.
That's right, and how all issues in human relationships are eventually, you ready for this?
Yeah.
Are eventually revealed through cars.
Oh, this is going to be good. I mean, I can see a PhD dissertation right now. Here's a title. Supplementary Emotional Conflict and Resolution.
Wait a minute, I'm writing it down.
Supplementary Emotional Conflict and Conflict Resolution in the Marital Industrial Complex. Huh? What do you think? I'm on this.
I'll bet you are. In the meantime, let's start by looking at the early stages of a relationship, meeting the person of your dreams.
Ah, yes. How it so often involves a car, somehow, doesn't it? But in this particular case with a caller named Chris, the involvement of a car was more than just tangential.
Oh, yeah. Listen to this. 1-800-332-9287. Hello, you're on Car Talk.
This is Chris in Colorado Springs.
Chris.
Yeah.
What's up, man?
My question is about how to go about meeting women in traffic. You know, this can be a depressing time of year for us bachelors.
Ah.
And I was wondering if you had any good strategies.
Wow.
You know, short of having a head-on or playing bumper cars.
Well, oh, in other words, how to get that female that you've spied through from your driver's seat?
Yes.
To first of all notice you.
Yes.
And then to actually roll down her window. Why would anyone do that?
Why would any Chris? This is a challenge. Wait a minute! Don't give up, though.
No, I'm not giving up because I mean I tried this for years.
I mean,
is it appropriate at a stoplight to just get out of your car and leave it there and walk around to the passenger side and knock on the glass to get in?
No, you'll go to jail for that.
Nah, no, that's not good. It's, I mean, this is going to be voluntary on her part. So either you have to have a car that she's interested in, for example, and I don't know how you're going to get her.
That's obviously why some guys go out and buy Ferrari Testarossas.
Testaronis.
Right, and that's obviously why, because it's the kind of a car that you think women will say, wow, what's that? Now, I have noticed.
Yeah.
In fact, this past summer, I was driving a BMW Z3.
Yeah.
On the highway.
Yeah.
With the top down.
Yes.
And the wind blowing through my bald spot. But as I was, I mean, I got enough hair to almost fake it. I mean, this stuff is blowing around.
Yeah, yeah.
And a car full of young girls had been following me, I noticed, at a distance. They were in the left-hand lane.
Be still my heart.
I was in the right-hand lane, and this car full of young babes is following me.
Yeah.
Obviously wanting to check out not just the car.
But who
who's behind the wheel? Boy, I'll tell you, you never saw a 65 Dart move faster than when they pulled up next to me and found out who was driving. So there is the
they
car.
They were disappointed,
does,
you might
they
say.
They were. They were. Yeah. But they wanted to see the car, and when they saw the car and who was behind the wheel, boy, they zoomed off on that Dart, and they were gone. So the car, obviously, you can buy an interesting and expensive sports car.
Well, I'll liquidate my entire stock portfolio first thing tomorrow. No, the thing that got me thinking about this was the fact that cars are so damn reliable these days that there just aren't any damsels in distress, you know, to be saved with their cars broken down by the side of the road anymore.
Yeah, and nobody wants to be saved anyway because all they'd want you to do is call the police. Nobody, don't get out of your car. If you want to do me a favor, call the police on your cell phone. Or they have cell phones.
And you can't trust anybody, and that's part of the problem,
right,
too.
Well, Chris, I think the solution that I know that guys like Berman used for years, because he could never get any girls to talk to him, was a dog.
Oh, the puppy.
A puppy dog, especially.
Yeah.
Mm.
It's got to be some. I mean, nothing is cuter. Yeah, I don't care if you're allergic.
Yeah, I don't like dogs.
I don't care.
Yeah, and my cat doesn't like the car very much.
No, cats are no good. But
see,
nothing,
you're a cat person.
Nothing is cuter than a little golden retriever, furry golden retriever puppy.
Six
I mean, if you didn't
old.
Have women all over you.
Well, now, wait a second. I'm cuter than a golden retriever.
I don't think so.
Oh, come on, will you?
No. No. Quasimodo could have a golden retriever puppy on the end of a leash.
Right. And Christy Brinkley would be beaten down the door to meet him.
Trust us.
I mean, you do have an interesting idea here, though, that, I mean, there's the positive side, the silver lining to a traffic jam is you could meet the love of your life if you only knew how to do it. So think about it, people.
So what do you use for if you were to roll down the window? Mm-hmm. What would you say to an attractive female that's in the car next to you?
Yeah, what if you were lucky enough to get her to roll down her window?
Or better than that, she turned to you and smiled.
Oh! Uh-huh.
What would be your next step?
I know, his next line would be...
All of American men are dying to know this. What would you say next?
I would say my car would like to get together again with your car.
Bad.
And we're both invited.
Bad. The females in the group.
Okay.
Karen is giving two thumbs down.
Two thumbs
Catherine,
down.
Six.
Six thumbs down.
Yeah, that's try up. Again. Try another one.
Okay.
There
you are. You're in traffic. You've been in traffic. You're going along.
Bumper to bumper.
The
you
car
catch
next
up
to
her.
A
she catches up
exactly,
to you.
Exactly. Back and forth. Back and forth.
And she just turns to you.
She turns to you.
And without any spoken words... She smiles.
Oh! And you and rolls down your window.
And she rolls down hers.
She rolls down her window.
And you say what, Chris?
Ba, da, da, ba.
Yeah, that's it! That's it!
You well, got it. I got it.
Well, I think Karen and Catherine agree that that's better than the first one.
Well, Chris, I don't know what the answer is, and obviously you don't either.
No, right.
But maybe we'll get some suggestions from people.
Well, that works good, but trust us, the puppy.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.